Hi, I'm Dr. Kenneth Mook. I'm the medical director here at Gateway Rehabilitation Hospital. The fact that I do my charting for the EMR and I dictate as well while walking on a treadmill is something that I do every day. I take it for granted that I can ambulate, but not every patient that we have at Gateway Rehab can do the same thing I'm doing now. It takes some practice even at 1.5 miles an hour to type and dictate and read your charts all at the same time. We have several different types of patients who can't do what I'm doing right now. Brain injury patients, stroke, and especially amputees who cannot walk because they don't have their prosthesis yet. So today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about amputations and what we do for our patients with amputations here at Gateway Rehabilitation Hospital. At Gateway Rehabilitation, what we do on Wednesday mornings is I have a sit-down meeting with all the amputees that are new coming into rehabilitation. I have a set of prosthetics here. One is a below knee and one is an above knee that I then discuss with them how these prostheses are fabricated and how they fit onto your residual limbs of your amputations once your limbs are healed. We have the above knee where we demonstrate its suspension and the knee joint, and then on the below knee we also discuss suspension systems and different ankles. So we have our simulator lab as well as our prosthetics lab, and so we do nursing training in here as well as we teach our patients how to do their own stump wrapping. So I want to demonstrate the difference between doing a figure eight ACE wrap versus using tuba grip and the speed that you can do this. So we find that our patients tend to like using tuba grip better because it doesn't take as much time. So when you're doing a stump ACE wrap, you use what's called a figure eight with the ACE wrap, where you always want to make sure that when you're going horizontal across the limb, you want to be at the knee joint or below the knee joint or above the knee joint. So this is how you do an ACE wrap, and then you would tape it and it would stay on the limb. It's not the prettiest, but that's a quick example. Now, as you notice how long it took me to do that wrap versus using tuba grip, which is kind of ACE wrap material, but it's in a tube. And so you can just slide it up over the limb, and then what you want to do is you make a 180 degree twist and then slide that up. And now you have a nice uniform compression dressing. So once our patient's incision is fully healed, staples or sutures or even steri-strips have been removed, we can now be more aggressive with shrinking down the residual limb. So we use a thing called a stump shrinker, and these come in sizes 1 through 5. And basically what you do is just the patient could pull these right on just like you do a regular sock. And then there's a silicone gel that's on the top that then creates a small bead of sweat between their skin and the liner, which then prevents the liner from sliding off. Once the patient has their prosthesis and are ready to start ambulating, we bring them to the therapy gym and use parallel bars initially and then move them off to a rolling walker once they're stable. This patient is now ambulating with their below knee prosthesis, taking short steps, but we tend to work on stride length as well as stride cadence. She's actually doing quite well for being this early in her prosthetic recovery period.